Hi everyone, Piet Kalemijn here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So in our last video, we had a look at how to manually create footprints. The question is today, how can we design footprints automatically or in a more automatic way? So I have a couple of things on this slide here. I will very quickly breeze through it. Basically, there is a couple of options and most of them are already integrated in your software packages that you're using. So one of the options that could be well known is SnapEDA, Ultra Librarian. These are online platforms that exist. You can just take a component there and use it. But also in your programs, your CAD software, there's integrated importers. For instance, in Altium, we have the manufacturer part search, there's plugins, and there is also vendor specific libraries. So without further ado, let's delve into it, how you can automatically generate the footprints that you need. So there's online libraries that we can use. Let's try that first. So it's this module, CO2 module. And we are going to use SnapEDA for that. So the interesting thing is with SnapEDA, you can make a free account. And you can look for a lot of parts. So you can search over 25 million parts. So let's look for SCD30. There we have it. And then there is some data available. So let's have a look what is possible. There is a footprint, so a schematic footprint, that's the symbol. Then there is a PCB layout footprint as well. Let's see if there is a 3D module. No, there is no 3D module model. So we will download the symbol and the footprint, and you can see here what the possibilities are. So a lot of different options. We're using Altium. So we're downloading the integrated lib here. Good. Now, to speed it up a bit, I have already imported that integrated lib. So this will result in a SnapEDA PCB lib. So here you see the PCB footprint. And then there's a schematic lib as well. This is what we saw here on the website. So you can just open the intlib here in Altium or draw it in there and you have these components. Now, if we look at the PCB lib, in 3D, you see that there's really nothing special added. So what you can do in that case is place a 3D body. But of course, we need a body. There is no 3D model in here. So what do we do for that? We are going to look for a step file. And I think, if I remember well, it is provided by Sensirion. So there's the download center. There's our CO2 sensor, technical documents, resources. There's a step file. We're lucky. So let's download that step file. And then we can easily import the step file in Altium as well. So you do that by place a 3D body. And then we will look for the Sensirion CO2 sensor step file. And it is now rotated a bit. You can of course rotate that back, but this gives you the impression. So you can also give it another color if you would wish. This is exactly the exact specification of our module, the SCD30. So this is a very nice footprint that you can use. Both schematic is there, the PCB footprint is there, and you have the 3D view. So that's one way of doing things. So that means we have our SCD30. What we can also do is use the integrated importer in the software. So I will show this with Altium. I'm quite sure in other programs there's options there as well, but Altium has a manufacturer part search. So we'll do that for our microcontroller, which was the STM32L431. So STM32L431. In this manufacturer part search, it will look through a lot of databases. So it has found an option here. And we are lucky immediately. So you see that there is a schematic model available and there is a PCB model available. What you can do in that case is by right click, you can acquire it or download it. I have done that before to speed up the process a bit. So this gives us the complete schematic pinout and then the PCB. And the PCB is even more than just this. So there's a version provided that has large pads, Then there's medium pets, and these are the smaller pets, I think. You would need to look into detail to see what exactly is changing here. And what is also provided is a 3D view. So you have already the exact dimension of the chip package. So again, a very quick way to import it. The only thing is here, be aware that you check the schematic, for instance. Are these pins really matching the design that you're using or the chipset that you're using? That's an important one. Then there is also plugins for import. So let's try that for our SARA, our 3G module. There is an interesting Mouser importer. So you can add that in Altium. Again, in other design tools, there's a lot of similar options. You are, of course, not constrained or restrained to using Altium. So we have found a module over here. We can add it to the design. I did that before, and that gives us then, it combines it in a library, but that gives us here the pinout. Could be that you don't like this pinout. It's a very big block with a lot of ground pins, this kind of things. You could redraw it into a nicer block. So that's something that I would do. Also, you really need to verify that the pins are matching what you need. And then there's the PCB library. So without any hassle, you have the complete exact footprint that you need for that module. So these are really interesting ways to do that. And then we also have an important one to mention as well, is vendor-specific libraries. So for instance, we will need a 2.54 millimeter header. How are we going to do that? Well, there we have it. This is what I was looking for, the word catalog. Once we are in there, there's a lot of options over here. So we need 7 pins. So this is the exact part number that we would need to use. There's 6 files available. And again, you see here, there's file provided for Altium, files for Cadence, files for Eagle. So you can just go ahead, download this integrated library, then add it in Altium. And adding, you can do that over here via the library's preferences. Once it is in there, you can use that library. So it's this one that we will need. And let's have a look here. So the integrated library, you will see that there's much more in there. There's a lot of possible pin headers that you could imagine. We are using the 6-1, if I remember well, 613007. So there's these options remaining. You can immediately place this in your schematic, done. And there's also even a 3D view provided for that one. So interesting stuff to be able to use immediately. But again, the main message is verify it. If you do an automatic import, verify that this is really what you want. So I hope this was an interesting video for you. I hope you learned something from it. If you have any questions, of course, as always, please feel free to put them below in the comments and I'll be happy to help. If you liked the video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. And if you like the channel, feel free to subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.